We know we need to do a better job than what we're doing now.
Iowa farmers already have taken steps to limit runoff from their fields, but they're working with the EPA to do even more. The BP oil spill is not the only threat to the Gulf of Mexico.
Yeah, runoff from farm fields right here in Iowa is also a concern. News Channel 8's Angie Hunt explains how Iowa farmers are working to change that. Angie.
Well, Stacey, this is an ongoing effort to limit runoff of phosphorus and nutrients, or nitrogen, all important nutrients for the Gulf of Mexico region, but it's the excess that's causing a problem. There's a lot farmers can learn about the corn and soybeans they'll one day plant in their fields by visiting Chamel's Biofuture facility near Huxley. But during this particular visit, farmers are also learning about ways they can limit the impact they have on the Gulf of Mexico.
The way farmers are farming now causes less erosion problems than there would have been 20 years ago.
But Iowa Secretary of Agriculture Bill Northey says there's more work to be done. That's why the state is working with the EPA to improve conservation efforts.
Ultimately, this entire region of the country, all of the runoff, makes its way to an ocean, it comes to the Gulf of Mexico.
The environmental damage from the BP oil spill is not the only threat right now to the Gulf Coast region. Brian Griffith, executive director of the EPA's Gulf of Mexico program, says the amount of nutrients making their way into the Gulf is also a hazard.
Nutrients are essential to the ecosystem health and well-being of the Gulf of Mexico region. We would be in dire trouble without them. It's just simply the abundance.
And farmers can do something to lessen that abundance, like no-till or reduced tillage, and building new wetlands or watersheds. It not only improves water quality here in Iowa, but downstream.
I think this is a win-win for both the people of Iowa and the people of the Gulf if we can reduce the amount of nitrogen and phosphorus that's going down the river.
Now, Iowa farmers are also working with farmers in Mississippi to work on different things, figure out what works, what doesn't work in terms of conservation. And there's also a cost, of course, to implementing all these changes. And Secretary Northey says the state and federal government are trying to provide more incentives for farmers to make the changes.
All right. Thanks a lot, Angie.